I'm Terry Bates. I'm director of the Cornell Lake Erie Research and Extension Lab. We're in a study where we're looking at different types of machine pruning in Concord grapevines for production. So probably back in the late 80s and early 90s, there was a lot of mechanical pruning that started here in the belt, and most of that was hedging or minimal pruning. Most growers want to go away from that now to keep their canopies open and their vineyards look more like hand-pruned vineyards. So when we started going back from hedging, trying to clean up our vineyards, our machines were very aggressive. We started using Justin Morris's machine from Arkansas, the Morris Oldridge machine, and we even made modifications to that to make it more aggressive, to clean up the hedge and bring those vineyards back to more of an established hand prune, cordon, cane prune system. And now we're into vineyards where we're trying to be as efficient as possible. So this vineyard that you see behind me is a metal post at every vine. Everything as straight as possible to make machine operation as easy as possible. And we are looking at using different types of machines. So I think the bottom line is there are several machines out there on the market. Most of them do a very similar job in terms of its pre-pruning, and we want to use hand pruning follow-up afterwards to keep that canopy clean and open and selecting both the quantity and quality of buds that we want to have uniform production year in and year out. So this trial behind me is looking at different methods of pruning.
Hello viewers, beautiful sunny day here in the Lake Erie region. My name's Jackie Dresser with the Lake Erie Regional Grape Program. I'm here with Andy Joy, and we are here to talk about this fancy new machine, hot off the truck. This is a V-MECH sprawl pruner. And Andy's here, and he's gonna tell us a little bit about how this works mechanically and how it's a little bit different than our Friday Joy Laporte pruner that we talked about in a podcast a couple weeks ago. So, Andy, what can you tell us about this lovely machine?
All right, so the sprawl pruner here is basically another variation of what our pruner is. So a lot of the parts you see on this look the same. And so we'll just start out. On the front of this, we have our regular sickle bars. There's no combers, as you can see. This is just basically cutting off the sides. When you come back in, you've got a top rotary cutter and a bottom rotary cutter, and that's just trimming your top, trimming your bottom to give you a box style, you could say almost hedge type appearance. And you can adjust these up or down to make it as tight or as big of a box that you want.
And then these are also adjustable.
Yep, these are adjustable in and out, up and down. You can twist them out, twist them in, pitch them out, depending on how aggressive you need them to be. One thing too with the rotary cutters in the back, you see the white discs down here on the bottom. Those are going to be your spring post protection to bounce around vines as well. And then it's also hydraulically open or closed. So if you need to be more aggressive, less aggressive, you can open those cutters up, you can close them down.
So as an operator, what do you feel, having run this through a few rows now, what are some of the pros and cons of this in comparison with the other pruner that we talked about before?
Pros, if you have a very vigorous vineyard, so like what we have here right next to us, we went through, it's going to cut everything off to length, it's going to cut everything off on the sides. It's going to give you a very, very manageable box that you can then come back through, and you can either do a quick hand follow-up onto it, or you can come back through and mechanically do something else later, like shoot thinning, or even, you know, bring up shoot positioning. So we may be getting back into that, so we may have to go back to shoot positioning, but gives you a more manageable. Con with it is going to be you have to either open up around every vine. If you have a dog-legged vine or something, you're going to open up around that. Having a post at every vine, like we have in the new vineyard here for the mechanization trials, it'll open and close around every vine. So every vine is perfectly straight. You have a metal post, it opens and closes. Otherwise, I went through our Vignoles, and that has a very tight vine spacing. I'm constantly opening and closing, and letting the spring assist. So
there's a little bit of fatigue on the operator.
Yeah, sitting there watching it, monitoring it, it strains the eyes at times. Also, just being, you have to go about a half a mile an hour versus our other pruner that we have. You can do a mile and a half. If you have a very light vineyard, you can probably do about two.
So maybe a little less speed, maybe a little more fatigue on the operator, but a little more control over your cane length and really cleaning up all of that stuff on the outside, even without a comber being in place. Great. All right, so let's take a little walk down the row that you're gonna prune. What you'll notice here is that, as Andy was saying, every post is actually trained up, or every vine is actually trained up its own metal post. And you still can have double trunks, as you see here. And what this is really allowing to happen is it's protecting those trunks from an aggressive pruner like this that, you know, that might end up coming into contact with anything coming out into the row middle. It's really creating more of a protection. And also, you know, being trained up the post, it's keeping it from the cordon from being tugged one way or another along the trellis wire itself. So other than creating a really uniform vineyard, so the operator doesn't have to be constantly opening, shutting, adjusting, moving up and down, you know, we really have a nice uniform, even plane for mechanized systems to move through. It also is doing a better job of protecting the vine from mechanical injury as well. So without further ado, Andy's gonna jump in the tractor and demo this thing for us so you can all see it in action. If you have any questions, feel free to leave them in the comments below, and we'll see you next time.